Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video, I want to put some animation on some SmartArt and a chart in PowerPoint. So I had to do this pretty recently. I've got a sample PowerPoint up right now. Let's go ahead and do this. I'm going to insert a new slide. I'll just do a, let's try this one, this content with caption. SmartArt. So on the main content menu we get here, there actually is an insert SmartArt graphic button, but if this button wasn't here, then I could just head up to the insert ribbon and there's an option for SmartArt. So either way works. I'm going to get some SmartArt. It doesn't matter which one we experiment with. I'll just choose this one right here. What is that? Alternating hexagon. It's cool. Click that, click OK. Now, if you've never used SmartArt before, definitely start putting it into your PowerPoints. Oh, by the way, this works in Microsoft Word too. Well, not the animation part, but you can insert SmartArt in Word. And you'll always get this little text box tool over here. I'm just gonna throw in some random filler text. Nothing too critical there. All right, and I can just click anywhere. So that goes away. Now, if I click on my SmartArt again, and especially I like clicking on the border of a SmartArt object, I'll get those options up there to add new text and things like that. And if I close that by mistake, don't worry, I can get that back. Yeah, so under Smart Design, I can click on Text Pane and it'll bring that back. So don't worry if you close it by mistake. Okay, but now we want to get into the animation. Now I'm going to click on the border of this SmartArt. Clicking on the border is kind of like selecting everything. I'll head over to my Animations ribbon. And I'm just gonna pick one. How about float in? That sounds pleasant. Now by default, it animates the whole thing as a group, but as soon as I choose the animation style, I can go to effect options and I can bring in one by one and it'll bring these in pieces. I'm getting a sample of the animation here. You can see how some pieces come together, other parts come separately. That's cool. And then once that's done, I can get to my animation pane and then expand this, and this will give me some details. You can tell by the icons on here which items are going to come automatically in with Animate with the previous item, or which ones require the mouse click, and I can change all of that. So for instance, I can see that this item here, if I click on the little drop down for it, it's going to be start with previous. So that means it's working in conjunction with the other animated item. But I could change that to start on click. Now there's a little mouse icon there. In fact, I'll do the same thing for this other one, start on click, and for the last one, start on click. Now, what does that really mean? Well, now it has to be activated. Let me just click slideshow mode for this. And so if I were to hit my space bar to activate it, I can animate each, or, you know, the entrance of each particular item. Now, of course, if you don't like that, I can press escape to get out of there, and I can change some of those items back so that they start with previous, and start with previous. So now these particular items are going to work in a big chunk. I'll show you that real quick. Let's go to slideshow mode. And by the way, this is the presenter view of slideshow mode that you're seeing right now. My actual full screen PowerPoint is up on another monitor. So, okay, there's one individual item, individual, and now we're going to get a big chunk of them all at once. Cool. Now, once you've got that technique down, it's not that tough, right? Let me just go ahead and insert a new slide. So home, new slide, and once again, I'll do content with caption. You can animate a chart exactly the same. Let's go ahead and create a really quick chart here in PowerPoint. Clustered column, perfect. I'll click OK. And I'm going to leave that dummy data on there. That's perfect. And then once again, I can click on the border of this chart, head over to animations, and I will do, let's see, what's a good one here? We don't want to get too crazy though. Sure, fly in, effect options. Let's go by series. Let's see how that looks. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Pretty neat. Now I've got the animations pane open already. Now what I don't want to have happen, I don't think I want the actual chart body to animate. I want that to already be there. So I'm going to remove the animation from that first item. So that should mean my chart is there. Let's see how it's working actually. I'm going to go to slideshow mode. All right, so the chart body is there. And then first bars, second bars, and then the third bars. Yeah, I like that a lot. So yeah, it's pretty easy to change that just using that animation pane. So definitely, if you're putting charts and SmartArt on your PowerPoint slides, don't forget to animate them just for a little bit of an extra interest, and it helps to focus your audience on parts of the chart as you go. Take care.